This lecture gives you a quick introduction to lean production. There are many ways to look at, define, and interpret lean production. I see lean as a complex socio-technical business phenomenon. To keep this lecture focused, we will take an industrial engineering perspective. We will introduce the fundamental lean principles and a few key methods. We will not look at lean through managerial or behavioral perspectives, although those perspectives are just as important as the technical one. The expression lean production was first introduced by an MIT-led international team of researchers carrying out the International Motor Vehicle Program, a global benchmark study of automobile production. The researchers found that Toyota's production system was way better than the mass production methods used in the West on almost all performance categories. The research team called Toyota's alternative model lean production. In 1990, Womack, Johnson, Roos published the landmark book The Machine That Changed the World, which provided rich detail of the benchmark study, became a bestseller, and popularized lean far beyond the automobile industry. In The Machine, the authors explained that lean production uses less of everything compared with mass production. Half the human effort in the factory, half the manufacturing space, half the investment in tools, half the engineering hours to develop a new product in half the time. Also, it requires keeping far less than half of the inventory on site and results in fewer defects. Clearly, lean was something mass producers should look into, and they still do. It has become apparent that whatever Toyota was doing, it was not an easy task to replicate it for others. While The Machine had demonstrated for everyone how Toyota outperformed its competitors, it did not describe what mass producers could do to become lean. That's why Womack and Jones wrote another book, Lean Thinking. This book contained 5 lean principles that have remained one of the most common way of describing lean. The 5 lean principles are: define customer value, then identify the value stream, create flow by implementing pull production, and then finally continuously improve the processes. Note that the 5 lean principles focus on value creating processes and much less on support processes such as leadership and culture building. They are also too high level to be of use in most settings. Therefore, I'm not suggesting that the 5 lean principles represents a universally valid account of lean, but they are probably the most used operationalization of lean.
The first lean principle is to define value for the customer. If a manufacturer does not know what the customer values, they will not have a long relationship. The second lean principle is to identify the value streams. In small factories with few products, this can be a straightforward task. But in larger factories with many products and dynamic demand, this is easier said than done. There are 3 ways to build transparency of value streams into a manufacturing system: by product process design, by layout decisions, and by good master data management. There are also several tools that allow mapping value streams in an existing factory, including all kinds of process mapping methods. In lean practice, value stream mapping has become the most common tool and is indeed a useful exercise. But for companies with many product families, complex material routings, and large variations in volumes and varieties, doing regular value stream mapping is a daunting task. When the processes are digitized, perhaps process mining can be a better and an automated alternative. Whatever tools are used, having transparency into the material and information streams that create value for the customer is a necessary condition to become a lean manufacturer. When we know what the customer wants and how we deliver that value, the next step is to create flow. Lean seeks a smooth flow aligned to the customer demand. Toyota's 2 pillars of just-in-time and Jidoka are key to creating flow. Just-in-time seeks to deliver what is needed, when it is needed, at the right place, in the right quantity. Jidoka is a form of in-process fault correction that makes sure errors are not passed on to the next process. Note that where traditional approaches would seek to optimize resource utilization, for example, run an expensive machine as much as possible, such equipment efficiency is only a secondary concern in lean. What matters is the overall flow efficiency. Lean offers a range of techniques to help create flow. Some famous examples include Kanban, a material ordering system, Andon, a stop and fix signal, Heijunka boards, a method to generate smooth mixed production schedules, 5S, a method for workplace organization, Pokayoke, a method to avoid errors from happening, and visual control, the use of visual cues to help humans navigate the production system and tasks. There are three enemies of flow: Muri, Mura, and Muda. To improve flow, the three Mus should be reduced or eliminated. Most critically, Muri, or overburden, must be avoided. When machines, people, or infrastructure are overloaded, flow breaks. Second, Mura, meaning unevenness or variation, always degrades the performance of a system and reduces flow. And finally, Muda, or waste, represent all activities that do not directly add value to the product. Such waste can be summarized with the memory jogger list Tim Wood, which stand for transportation, inventory, motion, waiting, overproduction, overprocessing, and defects. Note that many have unfortunately focused only on Muda or waste and not paid much attention to Muri and Mura. That is a cardinal mistake and will not lead to sustainable lean transformations. I suggest to start with eliminating Muri, then to reduce Mura, and finally look at Muda. The fourth lean principle is pull. The idea is to make every process pull value from the preceding process. In an ideal lean system, value would be pulled at the exact rate of the customer demand. Hence, there would be one piece flow with close to zero lead times, zero failures, and 100% value add. While this is utopia in manufacturing, that's exactly what lean seeks to achieve, which explains why the fifth and last principle is needed. Seek perfection through continuous improvement. There is no end to lean. It's a journey, not a destination. Also here, lean production offers a range of methods and tools to institutionalize improvement routines. For example, Hoshin Kanri, which is an annual policy planning and deployment process. Daily layered accountability, which is a series of short daily meetings where issues that cannot be solved locally are raised to the next level in the hierarchy. Kaikaku projects and daily Kaizen activities. Improvement boards and meetings, sometimes taking place in Obeya rooms. And A3 management, to mention only a few. Lean prides itself to a scientific mindset, where projects follow a plan-do-study-act cycle. In reality, however, it is rare to find projects that are run as laboratory experiments. Note that standards play an essential role in continuous improvement. If there is no standard, there is no way there can be improvement. This idea is often illustrated as follows. As the plan-do-study-act circle moves a full cycle, the standard is updated and works as a wedge to avoid the work processes falling back to the old standard. But if you think most continuous improvement work in organizations is about improving the standard, you're wrong. It is actually about keeping the standard, a very difficult task. Remember that the standard represents the best known way of conducting a task.
So that's the five lean principles and a range of tools and methods that constitute lean production from a technical perspective. Let me end by introducing the lean iceberg model by Professor Peter Hines and co-authors. As you see, we have only discussed one of the most common and visible elements of lean. The much bigger part is invisible and soft, and needed to enable a lean transformation. That was a short introduction to lean production, including the five lean principles and a range of tools and methods that help companies organize manufacturing processes and improve performance. But remember, nothing moves without people.